Hello guys, you're welcome to another episode of Funke Inspires. But quickly, I need to Google a song, a hymn we used to sing back then in school. I'm sure you know it's the second verse I want to sing. Yes, I am there. I am content with what I have, little be it or much. And Lord, contentment still I crave, cause thou savest such. This song brings us to today's topic, titled Contentment, aka cut your coat according to your cloth, aka peperipe, peperipepe, no go they do pass yourself, no go they do pass yourself. Contentment. But quickly, let me define contentment. To me, I see contentment as a state of happiness and satisfaction. Yes, you're happy with yourself, with what you have, you're satisfied. If you have a pair of shoes, you're okay with it, because someone out there does not even have shoes at all. He or she is going barefooted. So it is grace. You're blessed to have a pair of shoes. So that means you're content with what you have. I remember back then, I had just, I think, two or three pairs of shoes. Yes. I wear that shoe so they, that shoe begin to cry. Excuse me, it's enough. Excuse me, no kid me. I could count how many dresses I had then, you know, and I kept on wearing them with all confidence, with all pride, you know. I'm beautiful like that. I didn't even have wigs back then. I would just comb out my natural hair, you know, and I'm content with it. Contentment is very, very important. You just have to be satisfied with what you have. You don't have to look at another person's property and feel, oh, I want to have it. I'm craving for it. I'm greedy. I need it in my life. Do not be envious. Be cool with your spot. When you're cool with your spot, you have peace of mind. How do you know a person that is content with what he or she has? You will notice that person is very humble. You understand? That person is at peace with himself. That person believes so much in himself. You can see the confidence oozing. You understand? The person will not think, oh, I'm less important. My self-esteem is low because I'm not dressed well. That person will be confident whatever he or she is wearing. So that is how to know someone that is content. That person cannot stand greed. You know, there are some people out there, they are so greedy. They are not content with what they have. They believe, oh, I'm supposed to pay you 10 naira. Or I'm supposed to pay you $10 or £10, and boom, no, I'm not going to pay that. I'm going to take £3 out of it. I'm going to take $3 out of it. I'm going to take 3 naira out of it. I have to eat it. I need it in my life. Those kind of people are not content with what they have. But someone that is content with what he or she has is satisfied. Even if it is one kobo, it is $1, it is £1, I am good to go. You just have to be content with what you have. Be at peace with your spot. There's nothing bad in admiring other people. There's nothing bad in aiming for greater heights. You understand? It's not that you're at peace with having 1 naira and you don't want to work harder. No, you will work hard. But as you have your 1 naira, you're aiming for the best. You know, you have your goals set aside, which you want to achieve, you want to attain. But do not think, oh, I want to forcefully attain it. I want to forcefully achieve it. Do not be greedy. Be content with what you have. Like, look at it, for people on the gram now. You see a young girl on the gram, beautiful. She's driving flashy cars, lives in a posh apartment. She's always wearing designer outfits, you know, classy outfits, carrying designer bags. You want to be like her. You don't know what she did to get it. You understand? If you're not content with what you have, it exposes you to prostitution, to stealing, to cheating. That's why we have corruption. You know, you see, you have some politicians that are so corrupt because they are not content with what they have. They are going out for more. They want to steal from the public so they can have more in the reservoir. Why? Every malam within kettle, like I always say, every malam, they get their own thing. Make you manage the thing where you get. Cut your coat according to your cloth. If your cloth not 1 yard, sew blouse. Wear the jeans you get for house. Yes. No be by force to carry designer bag. Like Jennifer will say, Gusi gang, Gusi gang, Gusi gang. Where are they, my Gusi gang? Lato, Gride, Le, Gusi gang. Apamo, what gone, Gusi gang? A bag, it gone, Gusi gang. I remember an episode of Jennifer's Diary where Jennifer met these girls in in Emen Estate, and she saw them at the lounge. They were carrying designer bags, you know, beautiful outfits, their weaves, top notch, you know, and she wanted to be like them by force. She had. Jennifer was not content. She wanted to do it. She had to go and take the money from her business, and boom, she popped it into bags of how much? $2,500, $3,500, and she no reach that level. If you never reach level to buy them, no be by force. And you that think you can't repeat your clothes, you can if you don't have more. Where the law, where to say, make you no repeat clothes, may no repeat you. Let me give you, for example, me. If I'm attending an event and I feel, oh, I don't overrock this purse. This purse, I don't tire for this purse. Me safe, I don't want carry them. I know just won't carry them. I don't tire. Babes, I will enter the venue without my purse. I will hold my phone like this. I'll be like, hello guys, hi, ta-ta. Picture time. Can you just hold my phone, please? Picture. And I pose. Cut your coat according to your cloth. I remember when I did not have wigs, when I had these synthetic wigs back then, gosh. I was wearing it with all style, with all pride, confidence. And there was something that happened to me back then. Let me just share it with you. I attended an audition and I had just worn, you know, this pair of loafers, black. And I was wearing jeans with the t-shirts. And I felt, okay, these loafers really work, you know. And it was suede back then. And I didn't have the suede spray. I just used water. I just dusted it somehow. I think water and oil or something, or maybe oil spilled, and I've forgotten the gist. And boom, I went out for the audition. Before I got the dust don't gather for the shoe. And I still stood there in front of the crowd. And I read out. Yes. I acted very well. And I was given the role. And guess what role that was? My role in I Need to Know, where I played BC for 5 years. I was paid very well. I wasn't well dressed there. It wasn't my dressing that gave me the job. But at least I wore what I had and they gave me the job. I'm not saying you shouldn't look good. If you have it, wear it. Do not be envious of other people. Okay? Don't envy other people. If you have it, wear it. If you admire it, appreciate it. If you write it down that to buy list, when I make money, I will buy this bag. When I pay these bills, I'll buy it. Get your priorities right. Make a list of what you need to do with your money. Okay? And do it right. Be content. Don't carry all your hard-earned money and go and be buying. No. You have to save. Okay? And be content with what you have now. You can buy small and save for the rainy day. Okay? Contentment is key. Because when you are content, you'll be at peace with yourself. You'll be happy with yourself. You will not be sad. You see some people going about, when they go for events or anything, they'll be looking at the pictures, they'll be looking at them, doing their eyes like this. When you greet them, hi, hello, hi. And they start eyeing, they'll be looking at the shoes. Kilo, what is she wear? Okay, that bag now fake, no be original. The original no get hand like that. Na envy, because you know the content which you get. Be content with whatever you have, okay? So that's it today on Funke Inspires. So see ya, catch ya next week on Funke Inspire. My share no turn, it turn. Bye, guys.